Let's talk a little bit about the convenience store business. My convenience stores have a lot of small items in them. There's candy, there's pop, there's snacks, there's numerous items that you can walk into any convenience store and buy. So I thought we'd start with a couple simple ones and talk about how we determine what to sell that product at. The basic concept of business is buying a product at a certain price and then selling it at another price to make a profit. Okay? So the opportunity to buy at a lower price generally comes into play when you can buy things in large quantities. So when I'm buying candy bars for my convenience stores, I was buying them by the hundreds of boxes. I had 33 stores that I could distribute all those candy bars to. So I would go out and buy hundreds of boxes of candy at one time. I'd have a company deliver them, but I would have to pay for them. So when I would do that, I would be able to buy at a good price because I was buying so many at one time. The opportunity to sell that candy bar individually, one at a time, to my customers who would come in and want to buy a Hershey bar is how you generate a profit. You take the price that you bought them at when you were buying hundreds at one time, and then the price you sell that candy bar individually each to each customer, the difference between what you sell it at and what you bought them at is called a profit.
From his supplier for $1. And he sells it to his customers for $1. Is that a good idea for Mr. Mazzarini?
No.
Why not? Honey? Good girl. So if he bought it for $1 and decides to sell it for 50 cents, is that a good idea?
No.
What if he sold it for $1.50?
Yeah.
That's a good, okay. All right.
Good, you guys are getting the concept. So what Mr. Talata just described is the difference basically between selling at a profit or selling at a loss. When he said if Mr. Mazzarini was going to sell it at 50 cents, we'd be selling at a loss. Okay, you can't do that very long in business and stay in business. If you create too many losses, generally that's when businesses will fail and they'll go by the wayside.
One of my students brought up when we were talking about this in class, they said, sometimes you can go into Walmart or Giant Eagle or wherever it might be, and they offer something for free. And we had a good discussion about that. Because if you're giving something away, is the business making any money?
No.
Why might a business offer something for free or on sale where they might make a loss on that one thing? My class isn't allowed to answer. Why might a business ever do that? Offer something on sale or for free? What are they trying to do, Abby? That's a good thought, but if you're losing money on every single one, you keep losing more and more money. So why would they do that for one thing? That's the key. Why would they do that for one thing? Honey? Well, if they keep buying that one thing, though, they're losing money on that thing. What other ideas might they? Go ahead, sweetie.
People might
want to
come back, but if you want something on sale and they want to buy more higher price stuff.
Good thinking. They might lose money on that one thing, but if you go to a store, do you usually just buy one thing or do you buy other things?
Other things.
And are they making money on the other things?
Yes.
So is it a strategy to get people to come to your store?
Yes.